Winslow, Arizona. In the distance, you can see it raining.
You didn't say
here we are outside of Tucson still. We're in a small town. Not a lot happening here.
Nobody's up or moving. It looks like the Martians were here and picked everybody up in their space.
There's no La Mirada Theater here.
No beautiful homes.
No Long Beach Civic.
There's a
no
cafe.
Cathedral
that's
ceiling.
Where everybody eats on Sunday, Saturday night. Big town is up further up there, yeah. I remember we're by the railroad tracks.
Here's an old cemetery, it looks like. What is that? Is it a park?
Well, I think it's just somebody's backyard.
This must be Winslow. It's Winslow.
Is that the station there?
Must
no.
Be.
It's away from the...
We're leaving the Winslow train station. And this could be our backyard.
And it might at that later on.
Winslow, Arizona. This one can be crossed off my list.
Crossed off for what?
As a possible job opportunity.
Is it collect trash and sort them here? Sort your trash? That'd be a job for a lifetime. I usually tell you what's coming up, nothing.
We're coming to the highest point within these red rocks. This is Pyramid Rock on the left side. Also visible now is Angel's Peak, also on the left side. Kit Carson's cane can be found in this area also. Kit Carson was a colonel for the New Mexico Volunteer Regiment during 1864. He rounded up all the Navajo Indians and placed them in a cave before the long walk to Fort Sumner way back in 1864. The Navajos then were forced to walk 400 miles eastward to Bosque Redondo near Fort Sumner, where they were held captive for 4 years, being released in 1868. In the corner of their side on the base of these red rocks, you see some small facilities. This area is known as Red Rock State Park. Red Rock State Park was built to facilitate house Galapagos Tribal Indian Ceremonial that is held every year during the second week of August. During that time, the Ceremonial Association brings it together somewhere between 15 to 20 different Indian tribes from across the United States, Canada, and Mexico. They all gather here to do their social dances. Also in conjunction with the ceremonial is an all-Indian parade in downtown Gallup. All-Indian rodeo. A man, this animal, was wounded, and a buffalo ran across his valley, and the blood of the buffalo turned these rocks red. This is a traditional story that goes with these red rocks. And for you non-traditional believers, the main mineral within these red rocks are iron oxide. Iron oxide is used to make things such as paint as well as makeup. Animals in this area still follow their traditional ways. The majority of houses don't have running water, however, they have electricity. So once in a while you see a traditional satellite dish coming over the front yards. A traditional home to the Navajo Indians. The hogan usually has six sides with a door facing the east to meet the rising sun in the morning. It's usually a one-room structure with a fireplace in the middle. Over the years, the Indian women have been dominant over the male. It is said within the Navajo hogan, all but one side belongs to the female and one side belongs to the male. And usually that's a pipe that has a door on it. And this male has all his belongings on his wall. And if the woman finds out or thinks that he's unfaithful to her, all she has to do is remove all his belongings off his wall and place them outside the door. And when the man came home from the long distance, he usually came into the cabin.
We'd like to thank all the bingo players for coming up to play bingo in the dining car. It was a lot of fun. I'd like to thank everyone who played bingo with us today. Hope you had a nice time.
This is Las Vegas, New Mexico.
Is that the building where Billy the Kitten lived?
And I believe the old Harvey House is this building right here. This is one of the old Harvey houses.
Oh, look at the stores behind it, too.
Quaint little town, Las Vegas.
New Mexico.
New Mexico. This backyard, America. Lots of chunkin' backyards.
Not Orange County, though. Not yet.
How would you like to live like that? Everyone has an American car.
Big American car. Old American car.
This is New Mexico. I don't think I can find a job here.
None we have.
There's a party. It's Miller time. Now the train's picking up speed and we're out of time. New Mexico. And if you look, well, we're outside Las Vegas, New Mexico. And along the way, if you look real carefully, you could see the wagon train. You can vision. The wagon train, and you can still see the marks of the old Santa Fe Trail.
Taking a Earl Flynn, John Arness.
Every once in a while, you can pick up a wagon train print.
Police stopped here in front of us. We're on a stop, and I just got the squad cars in, but I don't know what else is going on for now. Oh, I'd say there's about 6 squad cars. In fact, every one that's in this town, I think there's more squad cars here than in Buena Park, probably even. Or anyway, La Palma. The train is stopped, and they're on the train. About 7-8 of them went in the train. And I'll get back to you as soon as anything occurs. We're still waiting for the return of the policeman from the train.
They're looking for someone who was born in Duluth.
They're looking for somebody that's born in Duluth. But I am in disguise, so it can't be me. Anyway, I'm going to get back to you as soon as there's any action. If there's a shooting going on, who knows how much I might get for this tape. Who knows? That's right. I could make money on this.
I'm Rodney King. Police violence.
Focused up on one police car now. There. That's what they look like here.
Did you get the town?
The windshields wiper was going. Somebody's sitting in there.
Did you get the pictures of the town?
Town? I'm more interested in getting paid for this.
I see police cars every day.
Okay, now I'll turn over here. To the town for a minute. In fact, I'm going to focus in more to get the real close-up of.
Look at all the four-wheel drives. Everyone has a truck here.
Engine passengers here in Marvin's car. 30 car folks. Marvin found in the restroom a red cigarette pack with a couple lighters. Marlboro cigarettes. Come on down and claim your cigarette.
Poison.
Left in the bathroom. Thank you.
Left in the bathroom. Cigarettes. Marlboro. Focusing in. Maybe they're looking for this person here. Right here.
Wow.
She was looking in the want ads for employment. There was about five of them.
Okay, that's enough.
Oops. That's enough for now. I'll be back in case anything happens out there. I gotta pencil it in first.
You see police cars all the time in LA. Not like you've ever seen a police car before. Here we are in Kansas City. This is the old train depot. This is Kansas City, Missouri.
Hi, everybody.
This could be where we come for the weekend. This is our sleeper. We're up on top, room F. And here's one of the tours. How do you like Kansas City?
We gotta hurry and go. He's waiting for us to come in. Very nice, very nice. I'll see you.
This is where Wally lives.
Wally lives now, but it's 2 million.
There's Sharon walking there. There's a bus there.
This is Kansas City. This is in back of the railroad station. Look at all the graffiti.
There's none there. None at all.
Just look through the want ads and there's a number of personnel positions. You could be looking at home. Here again.
Downtown.
We're looking at downtown. I could be working.
Up in that tall...
In this office, right there. Or maybe there. Or there. Oops. Going under a bridge again. Of course, we are looking at the older part of town, so...
Could be working there, too.
It's Sunday morning, so it's pretty quiet. But this is... Kansas City. This is where Wally Joyner lives.
$2 million.
Maybe Sharon Pearson.
$1,000.
If Missouri was good enough for Harry, it should be good enough for me.
A little chippy, a little chilly this morning.
But nice.
What's that up on top there?
Heading out of town. There's the birds of Missouri.
The area that I went over after they went over. Then I joined them afterwards.
Okay. That's really
but
weird.
I just went over. I can't remember the landing place. It was no big city. I mean, it was in the suburbs there. I went over as a group of everybody to like join my outfit. You know? And we went over in a barge. And of course,
you say about John?
Huh?
A landing
place. Yeah, right.
Well, I was. I was destroyed and dropped out in one of the LC bases in Long Bay. Actually, if I hadn't tried to get commission calls, which I failed to get through, I probably would have been a mechanic on a landing craft. But at the time, I was what they called the Jack Preston Navy on stalls, and we were receiving a landing craft every Bombay, but I haven't done that in the right job. We always really cursed Eisenhower for stopping it. We reckoned the Cold War would have been less difficult if we got through to Czechoslovakia and Berlin.
I think the Americans just took it, let's get it over and get out of there.
That's right, yeah. Well, in the long run, it might have worked out better because East Germany and those countries now have fed up with communism, so perhaps in the long run, that's the best thing.
Yeah, you never know until the deal
happens. Oh, well.
Which is like the one in America was over in Europe.
Can we live, the Mers is wider.
Here we are crossing the Missouri River in Missouri.
Why don't you let him give a commentary on communism?
Hello? I don't believe you, are we?
No.
Oops. We went through the last time they stopped. They'll stop here yet.
Yeah, they haven't stopped here.
And she stopped. We stopped where we're exactly where he
they
was.
They have a park in his honor.
It's a charming little town.
We're not downtown yet.
No,
but I thought I'd tell you.
Yes, thanks a lot. Yes, I'll get the camera ready in case we do stop.
Yeah, if they stop, just take a picture and it's where Walt Disney was born. Oh, we're out of it already?
No, we're not to it. Maybe it's a little further.
Yeah, it'd be thrown, you know. Kansas City that you just went out on Tuesday.
Oh.
Did you see it?
No. We'll manage to live.
Huh?
We'll manage to live.
Oh, come on, a former leader, you got to. Anyway, there.
Geography.
No one has a washer or dryer in this town.
They don't?
Everyone's hanging their clothes out on the line.
That's what they do in Minnesota, too. How many of you think are there in Duluth?
Here we have the downtown section.
Truck.
There's the train.
See nobody out.
At the park.
Folks, you'll find the questions. We have them upstairs in the lounge car on the TV. Also through the coaches at the forward end of the coaches.
This is
Marceline. And in the middle of the sleeping car, you'll find the questions to the contest.
There's their park. This is where Walt Disney
is. We're now at Marceline, Missouri, ladies and gentlemen. This is the boyhood home of Walt Disney.
There it is.
This is Marceline, Missouri.
Wasn't his, where he worked, wasn't it around the corner there?
I don't know.
Go on the outside there and you can get it.
Yep.
Down in the well there. You know, the well you can get a picture.
This is the park. This is where we would be sitting. These are Missouri ducks. Don't they look peaceful? They don't look hurried or rushed like the ducks in California. Just sitting there, minding their own business.
Thinking of Walt and Snow White.
This is Sunday afternoon in Marceline, Missouri. Quiet little town. This could be home, too.
Takes them when they start. You
town know. In Marceline.
Should I give him one?
No.
Put one on the... That's all I got in there.
Here's your train station. Marceline.
You don't want that in there?
Walt Disney's boyhood home.
This, right here, they're planning on building a new Disneyland.
Cute little homes. Everyone has a clothesline in Marceline.
Well, we got something, so.
Everyone has a clothesline.
Something anyway. The city.
In their little gardens. Everyone has a garden here.
Little tiny garden.
A garden and a clothesline at every home. Guess we're on the outskirts of town already. Everyone has a clothesline.
Did you want this?
Galesburg, Illinois.
When my brother was in the hospital when he got out of service. It was a paralegic hospital, Mark. That's why he was sent down here.
Cute houses in the Midwest. Here we have the traffic.
The main town is on the other side.
But that's okay. There's the coin laundry.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? This is Mike, it's Dining Car Stewart. I'm calling numbers on the waiting list. Number 3, party of 1. Number 6, party of 2. Number 8, party of 1. Number 9, party of 1. Number 10, party of 1. Please come to the diner. Your tables are ready. Once again, numbers 3, 6, 8, 9, 10. Please come to the diner. Your tables are ready. Thank you.
The Midwest has charming backyards. We just went by Piggy Farms. They had their little A-frame houses.
Heated.
They were all sleeping in their...